I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, TT. Two-turn baby girl, you know me. Still with the dolls that I grew beside.
Good morning, people. So, it's Saturday morning right now. What's up, Bikito? What are we gonna do today? What? A little shopping spree? Guess where we are going. PC Hoofdstraat. My favorite place to shop. Designer, hands down. Yeah, we're gonna head there, see what they have in store. Already contacted the person at Louis Vuitton. Also got some new collection items that are delivered there. The new Feral collection. And besides that, need some outfits also for here, the cold weather, you know? Let's fucking get it. Started my fucking bitch up, man. PC time. Spend some monthly wages in it. Oh! Let's get it, man. Back in Amsterdam. It does feel good, but for how long is the question? How
long? A few weeks is perfect.
I was chatting yesterday, guys. You want to create a life where you don't need vacation from. We have the penthouse here in Amsterdam. Meanwhile, we are in Dubai for most of the year this year. But it's all possible, you know? You don't need to be entitled to the place where you grew up, where you was born. Some people think, oh, I'm from the Netherlands, so I'm a Dutchman. I should stay here, blah, blah. If Netherlands is shit, if you're getting taxed up into your ass and you don't like it here, fuck it. Make money and leave, man. There are beautiful places also for cheap. Of course, I like Dubai because it's competitive, but there are other places, right? Thailand, Bali, where you eat a bowl of rice for 50 pence.
Colombia, Mexico, yeah. all those places.
There are many beautiful places. We are also going to explore more this year, maybe South of America. What do you guys think? Drop it in the comments. But there are so many places to explore. And when I'm here in the Netherlands, of course, it's nice because we are young, rich, successful. We made it up from a small town to Amsterdam. People know us. It's very good, but it doesn't mean that the Netherlands is so nice. Come on, when I look around me, it's all gray and this and that. A lot of people like Amsterdam, but that are mainly the people
comfortable, like, yeah, smoking weed all day, chilling, going to restaurants all night, yeah, partying. Also a lot of people from Italy, Spain, they all come here because here it's all relaxed, chilled out, smoke here and there.
Yeah, so that's
people don't care about
that's another
what
argument
you do.
I want to make for the people that say, oh, Dubai is really not for me. You're an uncompetitive little bitch. That's why you don't like Dubai, because there, every time you look around you, there are people doing more than you, more numbers, more money, people are more in shape than you. You cannot get the women you want there if you are nobody. I like that shit. Competitiveness is what's brought us to millions a month. You really think that if we stayed in the Netherlands doing 400,000 or 500,000 a month with good profits, that all of a sudden I would have started doing 4.2M? Fuck no. But we looked up to them bigger people online, but also we meet people just like last video, right? You saw it with Eric Spofford. He sold his company for 115 million.
Eric, you sold your business for over 100 million.
115 million, yep.
Do you really think that we'll walk into a guy like that here in Amsterdam? Fuck no. It's a good place. Of course, you are free, you are open, you can start your business from zero to whatever you want, but there's more, man. Ecom is a blessing. You can build companies online, you can travel wherever you want. So also go for that, you know? Getting a nice apartment in Amsterdam, it meant a lot to me. For my first apartment down here in the old South. Job. You see, people getting recognized everywhere, man. But come on, up until where we are now, it are all steps to success. Off to the PC, because
yesterday we did a little 100k.
Show
with 30k profit.
Show the people, Ruben. Hey, you know how you can spot a fake guru? You spot a fake guru if they never show you the payment slip, they never show you the receipts, they never show you the screenshots.
So this is the .com store, 85,000
bands.
And in the other stores, 15k, so a little 100k.
And now you fake guru, level up.
In the trap still wilding. I strip about 90 times.
Guys, there is no better music than rap music, you know?
No, but what the thing is, they rap what we live. Half of those fake-ass rappers, they don't even have 100k on the bank, you know? They're all broke. Only the bigger ones make millions.
I was just there, driving out of the garage, a song got on, and it said, I'm not a millionaire yet, but I'm keen to be. I press it away. Come on, I don't listen to you if you're not a millionaire, motherfuckers. We don't listen to you if you're not a millionaire. But come on, but Ruben is saying is true. Most of them,
they're rapping about Richard Mille's Rolex, spend hours, is this, that, but they're still in the trap with 50k on their
They rap the lines that we live right now. Come on, choose which side you want to be on. But
that's the same with half of those football players.
Bro, I hate the stigma of people thinking football players are rich, man. I pulled up from Dubai right now. Me and Ruben in the first class, the only ones there in first class.
And see all those football players sitting in business class.
We see those football players sitting in business class. And you really think because they have a couple million followers, they play for a big club, they make all of that money. Bro, I can pull up 90% of them football players. And I know I make more money than them because they also give 50% to the tax man.
That's the thing as well. And guys, you need to think it this way. Footballers on their top, they only play 10 years. So they make all the money in only 10 years. What will they do the rest of their life? Nothing. They start a fashion brand here and there that doesn't do money.
And the problem is
Then they're in the RDM.
How
can I make money
now?
Yeah,
because they live short term. And what also the thing is, they try to maintain that same lifestyle. Meanwhile, the money is not coming in anymore. If you are a baller, most of the time you go from 20 years old to maybe 35 max. Bro, when we are 35, where the fuck are we?
Yeah, in our fucking prime.
PJ's getting our shit sucked off, man.
Yeah, man, 100%.
No, but come on, the level of which you can grow as an entrepreneur, a businessman,
the older you get,
is priceless.
Yeah.
Because there is no, you're at this cap. There is no cap. There's no cap to how much people you can sell to online. There's no cap how big you can be. If I can say, I'm right now, I was 21, I became a millionaire. I did the calculation. I think the net worth at the moment is about 50M already. How can we not be billionaire, right?
Exactly.
Right? So come on, man.
Example, look at the football player Marco van Basten. He won Ballon d'Ors, and now he's broke because he invested all his money into
he invested all his money into some funds, and then when the funds came down, he pulled everything out of the stock market.
But if he waited, his funds were 10x.
Yeah, and also the thing is, it's fake confidence. Too much fake confidence. I hate that shit. If you are balling right now, it doesn't mean that you'll be balling forever because you're still working for a bus. Come on, man. Amsterdam pimping. But this is what you don't have to do. So now we went to the new store in UAE. That one was
and
sick.
2 days after,
different,
we are in the
level.
In the store here.
We couldn't cop too much there because we already placed the orders here. Let's check the men's section. Yeah. We don't do this in Dubai, you know? Just drop the whip in front of the store. Sick.
Mad store.
Way better. The other one wasn't dark.
Yeah, and this way more spacious. Here, the new collection.
Do a little outfit run, man. Here, we got the all blue Louis Vuitton sneakers. Cost like 850, I think. And we got the Louis Vuitton denim jeans, monochrome. Very, very exclusive. Never see people with that. Then we got Louis, light blue to match. And then we got Boda Skins jacket, timeless piece. That's already so got this good. One 5 years. Then we run down. Okay.
But I got robbed for them. I paid 1200 in the UK in Harrods. They're my scumbags.
Then I got this pants. It's Represent. New collection, Louis VV.
They don't
have this here in the Netherlands.
Where did you pick it up?
In Dubai.
Price?
We saw it on the video. I don't know. We just paid.
We don't check prices.
I think it was 1200
here. And then again, we get the Moncler Palm Angels collab going with the jacket.
That's how we do.
Always works. So I also ordered this set via my online personal shopper at Louis. But maybe they got some new pieces going on, you know?
This one, good invest. Already have it.
Basically, there is nothing that looks good that we don't have. Because everything that looks good, we buy it.
So people, finna try out new collection. Virgil Abloh.
Hey, but also something I want to show you. Look at that. You see that? Eco money, bitch. Little kid with a dream, man. Laptop lifestyle. We made it happen. Thank God. All praise to the big high.
Okay, so this one is too big, but she'll check if she has a size smaller. God damn, look at this one. Tracksuit with the pearls, all new. Let's see how it looks.
Show the outfit, fam.
Cool pearls in that. So, I like the top the most, but I might need to either adjust this one so it fits a bit tighter. Because you need both, I think, you know?
No, yeah.
Or just the top.
No, both.
But how is it with the pearls?
I like the top.
It's very unique.
Yeah, man.
And who else is gonna wear this? That's also the question.
Lil Uzi.
That's true. New t-shirt. It's very good. Meanwhile, Ruben was just checking upstairs because apparently they were handing out some fines. Hey, they don't want to see that orange Urus with that fat ass, you know, there on the sidewalk. But it was a good parking spot, you know. Definitely attracts more buyers to the Louis Vuitton store. That's for sure. They should thank me, man. We keep the economy going. What do you guys think of this jacket? Not sure. Colors are good, but I don't know.
Ja. Ziet er goed uit, toch?
Waarom heeft hij het zo neergezet?
Ik kon geen parkeerplek vinden. En ik had hier een afspraak, dus zo is het eigenlijk gegaan. Okay. Ik heb wel je klanten getrokken, dus de winkel vond het niet erg. Maar ik snap je heel goed. I have to put it somewhere else. But I'll just get my stuff from inside.
Dankjewel.
Is goed, dankjewel.
Heel fijn weekend.
Tot ziens. Of course, we're not gonna put it somewhere else. Just take it with you, because people steal it. Who parks it like that? Hey, before we guys walked in, there was no line, right? So we parked the Urus there. Now there is a full line. Okay, so we just spent a little 3.5k, not too much, because I already ordered stuff. Now we're gonna enter Hermes. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. So they had nothing at Hermes, so let's check Gucci. Hi. Hi. We make Gucci great again, guys. Want je moet het ook zo zien, hè. 2024, nu iedereen zit op social media. Iedereen bestelt online. De markt is bizar. Het is echt, het is ongelooflijk.
Guys, is this something for Sky or what? Don't have Sky with us right now. Still need to pick her up at my parents. Let's see, he's gonna grab the trainings outfits for me right now. Ruben is already trying his one out. Let's see. This is a medium.
Medium bulk is goed.
Top also good. There we have the set. I also had this one on in Dubai. You saw that in the vlog. Now we are here, Pacer Hoofdstraat. So I'm gonna cop this one. I love my tracksuits. So I also have the long one here. Perfect fit, right? Also got the shorts to match. Hey, tracksuits always work. Very nice. So gonna cop this one. Gucci denims that match these exactly. So. Perfect. All these items we're gonna get, this is what we'll get. Thank you.
Yeah. No, thank you.
How are we doing? 9.5.
Almost.
10k because we did 100 yesterday.
Yes.
So, no, we also did Louis V, so that's 14.
Light work.
Die was
super, dankjewel man.
Graag gedaan.
Thanks for the service.
Jullie bedankt.
Thanks.
En ik zie jullie binnenkort.
Is goed.
Dankjewel.
Bye bye. Hier een nieuwe Loro. Oh, opening soon. We need to go there, man. Yeah, we needed a Loro Piana in Amsterdam because every time we shop in Dubai.
Better to buy it here.
Mm-hmm.
Cheaper. No, I'm on my money.
Oh, the Urus is still there. To the bang. So now the sickest car of the whole block, where you live.
In Holland.
In Holland. Did already the girls pull up to you?
Yeah.
When you're driving in the BMW.
Can't handle it anymore. So Thijs, tell them, you purchased your first car?
Yeah, I purchased my first car. It's coming this week. So yeah, very excited.
A lot has changed, right?
Since 1 year ago I started working for Icon, and now we can drive a BMW, so grateful
the sickest car of the streets.
Also, So yeah, thanks Ruben to Ruben and Samuel for that.
Always, man. Yeah. And you worked. Yeah, you worked for it. Of course, you saw the opportunity and you go for it. And for example, you can also
see we give everybody the same opportunity, but not everybody takes it, because Thijs has also saw we had many people coming in Icon. We gave them an opportunity for a very good job, very paid well, and then they didn't took it, because Thijs, you also saw like this year we also fired a lot of people, but the people we fired were for a reason, right?
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, they don't see the whole picture. They
and you challenge yourself, right, to grow.
There's so much you can do at Icon. Very free in what you do.
And just you are also not comfortable with, for example, the designs you make or the emails. Yeah. You say no, this needs to be
exactly
better,
for example, when Thijs started, he didn't know how email marketing worked. He was fine in designing, but also not the expert in designing, and he learned everything in the job. So now he's an expert in email marketing. He become way better in designing as in the beginning, and he will grow even more in the next coming years.
And also what important is, if you stuck to one brand, you get that brand feeling and you know exactly what design works. You get also to know the email list, so because you can be a good designer, a good email marketing expert, but if you don't have brand feeling, that's I think
exactly, and that's why our emails are killing it, because we also worked with agencies in the past, but the agencies, they don't give a shit about your brand. They just
they
want
don't
to
look at the details.
No,
they don't look at the tone of voice.
They don't look at the numbers about the products that are selling good, the tone of voice, things like that. They just want to make some quick emails and push them out and earn money because of you, but they don't care about the brand. So that's the reason why we took everything in house.
Thijs, do you know how much your emails generated maybe last year?
It was 40% or 40% I think attributed revenue, and in total it was 6.1 million.
6.1 million, guys.
With 2.8 of flows, so the rest was all campaigns. But,
and finally, Thijs, what are you most proud of for last year?
I think cracking up the numbers. Also, the designing part is on another level like it was before. So I think the most proud about the designing and
Black Friday week was sick, right? So, you were banging out the emails.
4 or 5 emails each day.
Which email did the most revenue? You remember that?
The first email with VIP launch.
VIP launch. How much did it?
It was 120k.
Yeah.
Crazy.
One email.
Okay, guys. So where are we going? Right now we are going to our 3PL, our fulfillment partner, brand new warehouse. We've been scaling up a lot since we partnered with them. And also, fun fact, the owner of the 3PL, he was in a course of mine a couple years ago. He started a jewelry brand, and at one point he decided to sell it because he wanted to do different things. He sold it for about 100k euros. And with that money, he started a fulfillment business. Instantly messaged me, Samuel, do you want to work with us? And this, we got big plans. Didn't instantly start with them because, of course, we were already doing good amount of orders and it's a big risk, you know. 4 or 5 months later, we had some issues with our last 3PL and I said, fuck it, let's go for it. They also offer us, of course, good prices because they saw the potential in the brand and they want to have us as a client. Right now, this is already their third or the fourth warehouse they moved in within a time period of 1 year, and this one is the big one. So it's fully finished. We are heading there right now. It's gonna be sick to see. Also, see their side of the story. A lot has happened behind the scenes. A lot of orders shipped out. Also, of course, a lot of obstacles. Also in November, of course, Black Friday. We did 750k in a day. How many orders were it? I think it was 9,000 orders or something in a day, which is crazy. But good shit. So let's go there.
Okay, so we are at the location right now, the brand new warehouse.
Hallo, we hebben net een kwartier lang rondjes gereden.
Niet normaal. Die navigatie, die snapt
het
niet.
Toen zijn we aan de andere kant van het water, toen zijn we weer teruggereden.
Ik werd elk fietspad opgestuurd. Ja man, het ging nergens over.
Nee, maar wat mooie tafel.
Zo. My man managed to fix the go-yard bag, all white. Very good. Clean. So you also brought some t-shirts, right?
Nee, want die komt morgen.
Oh,
That's unfortunate. What's up, everyone? Sunday morning. Already had a good morning routine. So what am I gonna do right now? Gotta go biohack some shit. So let's go to my sauna. Wait, wait. What I also want to show you. What I also have is, boom, a red light. I use this motherfucker every morning when I wake up. I have a little podcast in, or I do some praying. Red light is very, very good for you. Do your research. There's many benefits, including better skin, better recovery, overall health. But what am I gonna do right now? 97 degrees. Walk into my private sauna. Let's get it. Man, Sunday is one of my favorite days of the week, I think. Sundays and Mondays. Sundays, because you reflect a lot, you look back on the past week. Also, I have more clarity on Sundays because most of the time my team is not working on Sunday. So I have more time to do more things for myself, you know? Where can I improve? Where can the business improve? And Mondays, I love it because it are money Mondays. Back to the grind. Man, thing is getting hot as fuck. I don't know if my camera will survive here, but yesterday, too bad, I couldn't film too much because I was with a couple clients of mine as well that are in the same fulfillment center as me. They are doing hundreds of thousands a month. Also, a good friend of mine, Wouter, who was my advisor during my exit process, he was there. I will try to catch up with him in the next week or so, and also bring you guys along. Also, gonna bump into some more clients while I'm here in the Netherlands, in Amsterdam, because I love this shit, man. There's nothing better than one-on-one, in person, being in the energy with the people I've been able to help, and them also sharing what this has meant for them, you know, making money with e-com, them changing their life, buying houses, getting cars. Also, next weekend, I have a housewarming of Dennis. Okay, guys, so I was filming, but the camera got heated, so doing it again. What I was saying is, next Friday, I have a housewarming of my boy Dennis, who started a few years ago in my course. Later down the line, he became one of our coaches, the head coach, matter of fact. And now he's been able to do millions a month with dropshipping, get himself a nice house here as well in Amsterdam. Also hooked him up with a bit of good interior choices, interior people. But no, man, all growth around me. Amazing to see. Just had a good session, just breaking a little bit of sweat. So let's make it a beautiful day. Peace.
So we have the Urus here. It's a bit dirty, but it's the best car. So we have it here in the garage. My guy here is gonna clean it up. What was the company name?
Zuidas Detailing.
Yeah,
you come and clean your cars.
For all your boys in South or in Amsterdam, you come to any place in Amsterdam, right?
I come to anywhere. I clean.
My man, he pulled up in the bureau. He's gonna clean the inside and the outside. So yeah, I'll check in. What is it? How much time you
like
take?
1 hour, 1.5 hours.
My man. Okay, top. See you in a bit.
2 hours later.
Yeah, man. So looks like new, guys. Die velgen zijn top, hoor. Yeah, top gedaan, man. Sowieso. So guys, this is the only water that he used. So tell the people, how did you clean it? With
a sponge with a lot of slats in it. You put it in the bucket, you put it on the car, and there's like a sieve underneath it, like a grid guard, and you spin it and the dirt falls down and it's clean sponge and you put it over the
Can
car.
Can you show the people?
It's very dirty from his car.
Yeah.
And then the sponge. All the slats in it. Yeah. So all the dirt gets in between and it falls to the bottom. So it's a safe wash, scratch free.
Wow, crazy, because normally when you would clean it, then...
Yeah, people come with a whole van and they go...
Yeah, yeah, exactly. This is perfect. So guys, we need some proper detailing done, because it does look like new. So yeah, very happy with the result.
Next time in Onuha Uncensored.
So I'm back in the snow, people.
We are on our way right now to Audemars Piguet. The
person that won the Rolex giveaway. He's here right now.